Hey, thanks for making it to Veterans Info Tap. I'm glad you made it. Do you rate for VA disability compensation? That's the question. And I wanted to kind of dive into this subject a little bit because 70% of veterans are not connected to the VA for VA disability compensation. Yes, 70% of veterans are not connected to VA compensation in any way. So the idea of do you rate makes a lot of sense because if you are connected with VA for your service-connected disabilities, you understand how wide the parameters are for connection into the VA system. So with that, hit the thumbs up, subscribe, share with a friend, all that good stuff. I truly appreciate it. So here's the deal. What the VA is looking for with regard to your service connection is kind of, I guess, behind a couple layers in your mind. So what happens is we tend to self-segregate out of VA disability compensation, one, because of the name disability. We assume because we can walk and we can talk and we have all of our fingers and toes that we're not disabled. Now, for most of us, if we were injured, if it's an injury, we understand that that is a service-connectable condition if it happened during your time in service. It's all of the other things. You know, maybe it's a cancer. Maybe it's some sort of a disease that you have. Those types of situations, these illnesses, are often thought of as, well, I probably would have had that anyway, or I was predisposed to getting that, or my parents, or my family history has issues with that specific condition, therefore I don't rate. We tend to think that the military had to have been the cause of whatever the condition is. So there's a lot to look at here, and the bottom line is what the VA is really looking for is, did you have any diagnosable condition regardless of injury or illness or disease, right? Doesn't matter what it is, basically a diagnosable condition that is chronic in nature or has some sort of residual effects. For those that don't know, that's Stan, my rooster. So here's the thing. Your condition could be something like migraine headaches. And I like to use migraines and even GERD, gastroesophageal reflux disease, as examples because these can tend to be things that we kind of deal with over-the-counter medications, right? You're talking about your ibuprofen, right? Your antacids. Thanks, Stan. Those are the things that you're looking for, to take care of it. And you're not really going to a doctor and getting diagnosed. And during your time in service, you just got a handful of Motrin or antacids, for example. Let's focus on the migraines for a minute. You could come from a family history of migraine sufferers that all started getting migraines at age 20. Well, sure enough, you joined the military at 18, and when you turned 20, you started to get migraines during your time in service. Well, you didn't run to the doctor and say, oh, I don't know what's going on with me. Can you diagnose me? You said to yourself, wow, I'm getting a migraine. This sucks. And subsequently, you would go to your medic or your corpsman and say, hey, do you have any Motrin? They'd give it to you, you'd take it, and you'd move on. You'd go to the grocery store, you'd go to the PX or whatever and get ibuprofen, Advil, Motrin, whatever, and you would take that with you and have it with you so you could deal with your migraines as you would have them. So you never documented it during your time in service. Now, this becomes a bit of an issue and a little bit of a hurdle when it comes to filing for your claim, because the VA is looking for three things when it comes to a successful claim. That is time in service, entry date, exit date. Okay, that creates a window of opportunity for most cases, right? There's always exceptions to the rule, presumptive conditions, presumptive windows, that type of stuff. But for a standard condition where you're trying to document it, you're looking at that window, entry date, exit date. So now you have that. The second thing is you need to have a diagnosable condition, like I talked about, that's chronic in nature or has some sort of residual effects. An ongoing problem is what the VA is looking for. The third thing is what they call a nexus. Now, you've probably seen nexus letter typically is the word you'll see. What the nexus is it's the VA saying, show us, the VA, the link, the connection between your time in service, that window of opportunity, and your diagnosed condition. Now, here's the deal. What the VA is not saying is, show me that the military caused it, period. That's not what they're saying. What they're saying here with the nexus is, show me that your condition manifested during your time in service or is a result of your time in service. Now, the migraine headaches work out well in this situation because, look, I joined without migraines. Partway through, I ended up getting migraines. Now, ideally, you got diagnosed. That would be the easiest way to prove that nexus. Now, if you don't have a diagnosis during service, if you don't have the diagnosis during service, you may have mentioned it on an annual physical health assessment. If you did that and you checked a box that you self-attested to having migraines, there's a form, I don't remember the number off the top of my head, where you self-attest to ever experiencing any of the following ailments, right? And there's like 50 of them, you know, painful swollen joints, sinusitis or allergies, migraines, heartburn, painful swollen joints. The list just goes on and on. It's yes, no, not applicable or whatever. And so you may have self-attested to having migraines. That's great. That's helping to build the nexus. Look, I complained about having migraines during my time in service. Now, in some cases, people don't even do that. You have nothing in your record with regard to migraines. And your medic or your corpsman, they don't write down the fact that they gave you Motrin, 800 milligrams, 15 times a day, exaggeration, of course, over the course of your time. So they don't have that annotated anywhere. Now, in that case, what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to basically build a nexus situation for yourself. Now, this is where a nexus letter comes into play. That's the doctor writing a letter stating that your migraines are at the minimum threshold, at least likely as not to have manifested during your time in service. Now, in addition, you want to write a statement yourself. You'll write that statement expressing that you started getting migraines at whatever, you know, time period during your time in service, and that you would just go to your medic or your corpsman and get your Motrin. You would go to the grocery store or the PX and grab Motrin, and you just had it and you treated it yourself and you moved on. And you never got it diagnosed while you were in service. You never saw a medical provider for it, anything like that, for fear of repercussion for most cases, because nobody, at least when I was in, nobody wanted to go to medical because of the repercussions, right? So you can, this is a known thing. So it makes sense that you would write that in your statement. So your statement is talking about why you didn't get it documented while you were in service and when you first started to notice when you first started to manifest your migraines during your time in service. Then you should get buddy statements, anybody that you served with that could attest to their knowledge of you having migraines and writing a statement attesting to that fact. You could also lean on family members that could express the fact that they never knew you to have migraines until you joined the military, and it wasn't until then that they noticed that you always walked around and had Motrin with you in your car, in the house, you took it with you everywhere. So that's helping to establish your nexus. You're painting the picture, so to speak, and work with your doctor to write that nexus letter. That would all become lay evidence in your claim. So you would submit all of that, the letter from you, letter from family members, the letter from people that you served with. You know, if you could get one or two letters from those individuals, that's great. A nexus letter from your doctor, the diagnosis from your doctor, and you would file all of that with your claim in order to get service connected for migraines. Now, in some cases, look, the VA, they're not going to always get it right. They may deny you your migraines. And if they do, you would then file an appeal. Or you could file a higher level review. So you could file a higher level review. That is simply having the VA have a higher level rater look at your claim. Now, you can check a box on there that says that you want an informal conference where you can have a discussion with them and say, hey, look, I have all the lay evidence stating that I've had migraines since I was in service, and share that with the rater and see what they do. You could file a supplemental claim supplying them more information, more evidence. So with the higher level review, thanks, Stan. The higher level review, you cannot add additional evidence. The supplemental claim, you can add additional evidence, or you can push it to the Board of Veterans Appeals and have a judge review your file, and then they can make the ruling for you. So with that, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you. Have a great one. And remember, if we don't take care of each other, something went wrong.